built this awesome studio. And I mean built, by the way. They actually were like sawing bits of wood and everything when we like got here. They literally have built all of this around us. I wish you could see it all. They've put so much work into it and done such a good job. So, you know, do spread the word. Right. I think we're going live.
Yeah.
I can stop the filler material. The bad news is, I mean, am I? I think I'm the camera. Yeah, I am. So that's not a good thing. Okay, so we've got the knife round, and you can see that imaginary on this CT half here. So we're just going to get the shanks in, which turn the half, although no one ever seems to swap in CSGO. So I will try and control the camera as ably as I can. I can't get all of that.
Counter terrorists win.
Yeah, I'm pressing the button. Oh, it's got music. So there you go. Imaginary win the knife round. They're actually, now that I've said it, are they going to swap? Yeah, they're switching. So they are going to switch sides. So we're going to see imaginary move across to this T side. And that means that TCM are going to start CT. So as we thought, the knife round pretty much determines who's going to be T. And terrorist, as we talked about earlier in the game, do have a slight advantage. My learned friend on the left. That's threat. So yeah, just joining us. Game is about to go live now. Tell your buddies, spam the link. It's about to go live. The first game of the Mad Catz CSGO Invitational, streaming it with Face It, thanks to Alienware.
I'm going to see pistol round. Let's see if they they have many updates with the pistol, so let's see if we can see some 5-7 maybe.
Well, yeah, I mean, the pistols are considered dramatically overpowered at the moment, so I'm just going to have a quick scan around, and again, apologies if I'm flitting at the moment. I will get auto director sorted out for the next game. We'll just have to bear with all the crew. We can see that we've got Stavros there just having a little spam into that lower B area. So, Imaginary have gotten themselves into position and actually made this opening frag. We're going to see some rotates coming around here, and TCM. Flow pops out of that B bomb site to stop them pushing through mid, and is going to take down the beleaguered Oz Striker. So there's his first death of the tournament. I'm pretty confident it won't be his last, but in the meantime, Imaginary have got onto this B bomb site, and the bomb is going down. So you can see that Flow is going to be trying to rotate. You can look at the Imaginary. They've got Uzi here in a very good position. He's managed to, assist Shoxi in getting that kill. But TCM have done a great retake here in the pistol. And as we were talking about the B bomb site being quite easy to retake with one flash over the top, that's exactly what TCM have done. Flow have come in for the defuse. That's going to give them the pistol round and a great platform to build on the CT.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, big risk there from Imaginary going up middle on the pistol round. I never liked that on the pistol round. Even if you get the first frag, as you did there, you get so... people will just spam you through the smoke there. I think we saw one guy with 1 HP and one guy with 6 HP after they went out middle, so that's why they lost that round.
And I can see as well, we've got some GoTV chat coming in. Let's hope Oz goes 0 for 30. That's not very nice. What are these guns that they've bought here? They bought 5 of them. I should probably know. I'm a caster, but what are these? I'm putting you on the spot.
Yeah, it's one of the new submachine guns.
Nice. Yes, I got that.
Well, it's quite common to buy them nowadays. It's you get more money when you get frags with them. But I think one of the more common reasons to use them is because you give the opponents a lesser weapon if they manage to kill you on their eco. Plus, it's easier to strafe and shoot, which is better on eco rounds.
Yeah. And as we expected there, the eco round does indeed go the way of TCM to make it 2-0. And we're going to see another full eco, I'm guessing. Oh, no? Look at this. Major's bought an AK, so... They're doing a buy, so that plant has come into play. So I will bring you in tactically when we have a look, and they've bought their guns. So they've got 5 AKs, and I keep forgetting I need to keep switching the camera around. So we're just having a look, and you can see that they imagine we have a player just positioned in mid. They're
seems
not
like
trying
a slow
to give away too much.
Slow standard round, and I just want to talk about them buying those submachine guns. I mean, they all bought Colts now, so basically they threw away like 1,400 per player. Like,
and that flash over the top is going to see Stavros taken down. We got to it just in time. So Imaginary here have made the entry pick, which is exactly what they need to do. But as you said, they've thrown money away hand over fist, and right now these guns not coming into play. And then Shoxy Jesus, he's as he likes to call himself, he's going to get a kill as well. So you can see that he's going to be through mid. He's just going to spam that spawn area the CT spawn, and he's going to camp in there. In the meantime, it's Ozstriker that's going to get a nice little double. I tried to get to him in time to catch it, but Ozstriker just went up short and got the kills, and everyone's going, yeah, it's Oz. I think by making him this tragic underdog figure, everyone's going to really get behind him. So that was a great early buy for the French. And of course, that means we are going to have to see an eco now, surely, from TCM.
Yeah, absolutely. And just think if they didn't have bought those submachine guns, they might. I think they will have to have two ecos now.
Mm. Oh, so you think it'll be a double eco? So about
that. Yeah, I think they'll go for double eco. They should go for double eco, especially since they bought P250s now.
Okay, well, we will wait and see if that comes to pass. Threat, of course, is our expert, so he's the guy to listen to. But I'll tell you what, this TCM eco round, it's not going according to the script. Ozstriker getting taken down by CLY as he comes out along. So Major is going to be rotating now from that upper B bomb site, going all the way back to T spawn, and of course that means that CLY's got an 8k now, but he is going to get taken down by Shoxy. So battle of the aim stars. Shoxy though is going to drop back, I think, as well. He's just going to drop back from long. No, he's not. He's actually going to hold it. So he's just waiting to see if there's any CT pushing activity. We'll quickly go around. You can see that Major is wrapped around. He's got the bomb staring down into mid. It is a 4v3. Situation in favor of TCM, who of course did eco, but at the moment you would still fancy imaginary just based on the balance of play. No guns in German hands, which is definitely how the French like it. So they're coming up long now, imaginary. They're just going to be doing the crossover, they're going to smoke it, and Shox was aware that there was Stavros just hiding behind that box. Bomb is going to go down. You can see there's another kill coming in for Imaginary. So it's now a 2v2 situation. Guns very much in favor of Imaginary. And that's going to be incredibly hard here for TCM. And Shoxy's going to get one kill, and Struxy's going to answer back. But in the end, Shoxy absolutely played that to perfection. Yeah. I mean, he just did that so well. But it was a very good eco round for TCM.
Yeah, absolutely. And it just shows you the power of the P250. It's only $300. It's like, it's no reason not to buy it. Like, it's so much better than the P2000. And we actually see dual elites from Tornado Tony.
I mean, again, this is something Tornado Tony used to do in Source as well. He would seriously, he would buy on his eco round, he would buy dualies, he would just run super aggressive somewhere, just spamming away and just, you know, often get a kill. But Stavros is the first to fall in this round, while Shox gets his nice little opening frag. And Shox is basically hot to trot at the moment, looking very good, very solid. His aim is working, so we're going to stay on him for a while. You can see that the bomb is also coming around for Imaginary. Uzi's going to have a little sneaky peek at long. He's getting a bit keen, but he's not going to find anyone there. They've checked all the spots, so it looks like the bomb is going to go up long. You can see MSHZ is just going to be holding mid with an AWP in that very German fashion. But while that happens, Flo is going to get answer back, and he's going to take an AK. Uzi's going to be spamming away into that area just on short. And the flash is going to come in. They're also going to put a smoke down. This is going to enable them to get the plant. You can hear that bomb just going down as well. MSHZ in that delayed position in T-spawn. He's going to get a kill. And Uzi's going to take the player Struxy that wraps around at long. So we're just going to stay with Uzi at the moment. Looks like he's going to head towards long and just lock down that avenue of attack. So just trying to see where they're going to rotate. I don't know if TCM are just going to save. Yeah, it looks like they are. You can see Flo's just lurking in the basement there in MB.
And just a standard antique around, not much to say about this round.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, but well, you know, you were right again though on the double eco. Yeah. I can see you actually know what you're talking about more than me.
Maybe we should get a name for that MSHZ guy. Like, it's very hard to say, like,
well, yeah, I'm not going to try and pronounce that. He's going to be MSHZ. Like, no doubt someone on the chat will be telling us how to pronounce it. They'll all have their own theories. So, but there we go. So that is going to put Imaginary, you know, in the lead, 3-2. Those back-to-back ecos. So we're going to see what happens in this next round. It's going to be a big kind of momentum change coming in. So let's see what you can see as well as a Galil for Ozstriker there.
Bomb is going inside B with only two guys going there. No,
yeah. And I'm watching Tornado Tony. He's just put down a smoke. He's getting multiple flashes on that B bomb site. So he's going to back off, but Flo's in a very good position. You can see as well that Uzi's just took some damage, and there is going to be this trade-off, so let's try and get there. MSHZ is going to get a kill, Mage is going to get a kill as well, but they are going to get traded back. Flo, he's doing work, and he kills, so Strixie got one for TCM earlier, so it is a 3v3 situation. TCM just have the advantage on health at the moment, and the bomb is planted. Imaginary just holding it. You can see MSHZ just watching the rotate from lower, and everyone else for Imaginary are just staring at boxes to avoid the flashes coming over the top, which is so powerful. You can see CLY and Stav. Both got some kills here, but Shoxy's going to answer back, and in the end, Stav is going to outgun Shoxy. He's been playing particularly well. They are going to get this defuse, I'm pretty sure. Yep, there you go. I have got a kit straight on it from CLY, and they played that one again. They're retaking B so well right now.
TCM. Yeah, exactly. Great retake there from TCM, though I think the tactic from Imaginary was really, really good. They actually threw two smokes inside B, Shoxy hide inside those smokes, inside of B2, like in a corner, and he just waited for his three teammates to push up middle and create a distraction.
Well, that is, it is going to tie the game up. We will have a quick look at the frag charts at the end of this round to see who's hot and who's not. But you can see as well that Imaginary Gaming are going to be able to buy still. So this round could still go either way. You have to hand it to TCM. They've acquitted themselves very well. And they are retaking the sites well and even playing well on Ecos. So still a very, very close game. We'll have a quick flick around. Got to keep them. See that Major just having a little spam around in mid. Narrowly avoids, I think that was an AWP. Just going off there, so they are going to go up short now, Imaginary. I mean, they're getting some good penetration here. You can see TCM effectively giving them short. They're not playing anyone close on catwalk. Able to get up there, but that's a great little peek there from CLY. He's going to get one kill. Struxy's going to get another one. So all of a sudden, they're in a 5v2 situation, TCM. Feeling very comfortable. Shocks just trying to tap away. He's going to get that headshot on Stavros. That's why your tap guys never go full spray. And Shoxy's just trying to stay alive here, just trying to move and evade bullets like the Matrix. He's looking up long. He has got a smoke here, and he knows that there's a TCM player close. He's going to have to get a kill if they have any chance, and his teammate has let him down, MSHZ, and in the end, Struxy's just going to peek through the smoke. Shoxy unable to get the aim, and TCM are going to go back into the lead 4-3. Quick look at the frag charts. You can see that CLY has gone on 9-3. He's at the top, and no surprise, Shox top for Imaginary on 11-4. So we are going to see another eco for Imaginary. I'm going to talk to you a little bit, Threat, about just how you see this game going tactically. You know, if you were Imaginary right now, is there anything you would change?
Yeah, I think I would have more guys going in the stairs area. They have tried to push long now, and it seems like TCM really has long shut down. They have one guy hidden in the big pit, just looking right down, so he can't get flashed. And yeah, I think they should try to going more guys in cap.
Well, while they're getting butchered by this TCM eco, you can see Stavros happy to gobble up those eco frags. Mage is going to get this bomb down, he's just going to get the plant. So in the end, it's a very good eco because that's going to play a part in the economy. Certainly the money will be a big factor, but not going to be able to do too much more than that. CLY looking very, very good at the moment. That 1.6 aim that we talked about definitely coming into play. Did you ever play against CLY at any point?
Yeah, I played him in a lot of online games, actually, like many different ESL leagues and stuff like that. And
yeah?
He's always been decent.
Yeah, decent. Again, you like to use that word. It's like a backhanded compliment. I like that. So he's just decent.
Yeah, I choose my words wisely.
Right, okay, well, it is going to be, I'm telling you, it's a great cut and thrust game at the moment. Every round has been particularly close. It is TCM that have the advantage at the moment with 5-3. So not what we were expecting when we were talking about it in the build-up. We felt the Terrorists would have the advantage, but it is another buy round, and it looks like Imaginary are playing this again, just doing what you were saying about going short. But the CLY just getting two kills and just shutting it down before Ozstriker takes him down at the back of the queue of people. He's going to get a face full of nades. He's very low at the moment, not just in terms of skill, no, I'm joking. He's got very low HP. That nade landed on him pretty much flush in the face, but CLY just looking huge at the moment and really kept TCM in it, even though it is a numerical advantage for Imaginary. It hardly is. They probably have less health, than TCM with it there too. So we're just going to wait to see how it goes, but bomb has been planted, and you see there's the nade coming into place. Striker gets double naded. Mage is going to answer back. Mage is going to go for the cut for Tornado Tony now. And of course, MSHZ's in the pit. He is going to get a great peek and kill in that 1v1. It was going to take something special from Tornado Tony to take out an offer in the pit at that distance.
Yeah, actually, I would almost say that he should save his weapon in that position.
It's really?
Like, almost. It's like he won't miss if he's a good player, so it's... I don't know.
no guts, no glory. Like, you've got to go for these clutches, man. It's a tournament.
Yeah, maybe it's easier in CSGO. I don't know. In 1.6, it was basically impossible.
We're getting a request from Bot or Striker to deactivate the chat. I'm quite enjoying it. I'm not going to deactivate it. I've been enjoying it. So, sorry. Request denied. All right, let's get back to the game. And you can see, again, it's a very slow start from Imaginary. They have got guns in their hand despite losing that last round. So it's 5-4 for TCM. It's as close as we would have expected.
They're doing their short push here again.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I'll quickly get to that. And you can see Shox has gone oblong as well. So while Shox is going to take down Uzi, and CLY is going to get another kill, no surprise there. Shox has got all the way up long and probably should have done a bit more damage in getting into that great position. They were really distracted, and now it's on Shox to pull off something special, which is definitely within his regular repertoire. He's pretty low at the moment, but it is a 3-on-2 situation. MSHZ really needs to come to Shoxy's rescue here and be his wingman. So they know there's one long. You can also see as well there's going to be people coming from the spawn area, and Shox has got a couple of nades here, so from fallen colleagues and foes alike. Bomb is going to get planted. It's going to be a safe plant. He can't really plant for long in this situation. Flash is going to come over the top. He's going to try and use his movement to hide behind these boxes. He's looking down into that spawn area. You can see MSHZ unable to put that up to use, and that's going to be a fatal error that is going to tie the game up. And, well, it's 5v5. So have Imaginary started getting the ball rolling? Are we going to see a major momentum shift towards the front?
I don't know, really. It feels like Imaginary makes the right decision, but they're currently getting outplayed individually. I mean, they created really good positions for themselves coming from that short area, but they basically just got out-aimed. It's just that simple.
What do you do when you're in that situation, when you know tactically you're reading the game correct, but individually you're getting out-aimed?
You panic. No, it's basically, if the tactics are working and you're still losing, it's like the hardest position you can be in.
So I mean, there's nothing you can do? You can't try and get favorable matchups?
Well, you have to like push each other to aim better, basically. I mean, yeah, that's all I can say. They really should like... It's like you get into this kind of bad mood when you start losing all the aim duels. It's like your aim just keep getting worse and the opponent gets more and more confident. You just have to break that. You have to like out-aim them one round. Like, yeah, we can still out-aim you.
Right.
It's so a lot of a psychological game going on.
Well, you can see as well that it is technically an eco round, but Shox did buy an AK. So whether that's going to come into play, whether he's saying that we can, you know, I can do this individually, give me the gun, I'll win us a round, just back me up. It's hard to speculate not being at the event, but you can see that Imaginary have got the numerical advantage. It's a 5v4 situation, despite being an eco, make that a 5v3 situation, and it's all just kicking off. But while they've managed to get into this long area, you can see they've been trading frags, and they're going to get this plant on this A bomb site, and it's, CLY again, just taking down our striker from distance. Uzi's going to answer back and take down CLY. You can see now it's a 2v1 situation.
No armor on Imaginary.
Yeah, I mean, well, obviously not. I think it was pretty much only Shoxy that bought. So Flo's having a look around. It's a great shot from him on MSHZ. It's all on Uzi now. It's a 1v1. He's going for the jumping pistol. I'm not sure I'd be doing that. Oh my word, it's worked. Has he got enough time to do this defuse? 5, 4, 3. No, oh. Boom, not enough. So in the end, I don't approve of that. I don't approve of jumping pistol clutches.
No, and still, like, that aim duel was not it. It showed that they're really nervous or
something. Yeah, I was going to say, you couldn't really call that an aim duel. It was just like two people just spamming mouse one as fast as they can while jumping up and down on the spot. It was horrible.
And it looked like the Teal-like started to look down on the ground for some reason, like he was trying to hide to buy time for the bomb.
Yeah. Well, quick look at the frag charts while we're getting this round underway. You can see that CLY, 15 kills for him and shots, 15 for him. So they're both evenly poised. They've been the real guys to talk about this round. But it's things are kind of looking good for Imaginary. They managed to put together a run of rounds. They've now got this full buy coming in. TCM are on an eco, and even though TCM have performed pretty well on ecos, it's still got to favor the French. And Mage is going to pick up two. You can see as well CLY in mid. He's unable to do anything. And Major coming up with a big three, man. And that was, again, an impressive round. So that is going to tie it up for 6-6.
Is it too late, however? I don't know. Mm. Maybe it is.
I don't know. I think what the, you know, what Imaginary are doing are, you know, it's actually looking quite good. Like, they've started, I think, starting to hit their stride. You know, we did pick out some weak links in their team and other such things. But, you know, TCM are maybe looking to wilt a little bit under this pressure, so.
Quite interesting how TCM use only two guys on A. Okay, now one is rotating, but they have, like, only two guys on A, like, most of the time.
Yeah, well, I mean, this is much, much slower round as well from Imaginary. I mean, I think they're very much sure of how they have to get the momentum going. And, you know, 6-all, 3 rounds left in the half. You know, they want a 9-6 half. They definitely need to really drive home any advantage they have. So they're very wise to play this round slow and just look and see if they can get the easy picks. They know TCM are on the ropes, but you can't go all out to deliver that, you know, knockout uppercut. TCM have managed to get the first two kills in this round, and CLY again playing a big, big part in that headlong. That is going to give Imaginary the onus to push up short. They're going to do. Oh my God! What have I just seen? MSHZ absolutely rips Shoxy's head off. And there we were talking. Oh my God! There we were talking about how important it was to get momentum going. And bang, absolutely ludicrous point-blank team kill that eclipses anything our strikers could have done. That is horrendous.
Yeah, but still it's mostly bad luck. So I hope they can recover from that little incident.
I'm not sure you can. How do you recover from that? Like, if your teammate does something that spectacularly bad, how do you do it?
Well, it's a TK, it happens sometime, and it's the most common is like an AVP headshot, like they run in front of you like at the exact second you shoot, so I guess they have been, that has happened before, so.
Right, well, Imaginary are going to have to put that behind them, but of course that losing that round did give TCM the advantage again, so we're going to have a look, and it looks like some sort of a crazy mixed buy going on. You can see as well, Imaginary have to break down in communication because they were arguing about that. While that happens, you can see Tornado Tony's going to get a kill, Shoxy's going to answer back, and Mage's going to answer back, so this mixed buy paying off at the moment. They have got another plant on B bombsite. That's definitely been the spot where they've had the most joy, I would say, over the course of the game, but here comes the retake from TCM. We know how good they've been. So what they're doing is they're just going to quickly jump through this window. Is he Stavros? He's toying with the idea. Then he's going to go for it. He's going to drop down onto him. And he's going to get that kill on Shoxy, that flash. Definitely playing a part. And look at this. Absolute decimation. Uzi, the last man standing. We're going to quickly get to him. He's outside the door. And in the end, CLY is going to take him down. No surprise there. And that is a great retake again from TCM.
Great retake, but still 4-on-3. You have the B-bomb site. They're not supposed to lose that.
So you're saying that's a fail?
Yeah, that was a fail. It was a pretty bad decision from, I think it was the Uzi, who's decided to flank them. Mm-hmm. When you have a one-man advantage, you can just stick together, hold the bombsite, and you will win.
Well, it's the last round of the half. You can argue that it's an important one. There is definitely a difference between 8-7 and 9-6 in terms of what you need to do moving forward for the game. So we're just going to have a quick look around. But this is Imaginary. You know, did that team kill play a part? As Threat says, they probably should have been able to hold that bombsite. But it is a fantastic retake from TCM. Credit where credit is due. You can't put everything down to failures. Sometimes it's just exceptional play. So Imaginary, they understand the importance of this round because obviously with the pistol rounds playing such a vital part in the way this works. They are going to push out of mid. It looks like they're going to do the mid to B strat again. They are going to get that kill on Tornado Tony outside of B. That is going to tip the gap that they're coming in. And you can see that Flo's going to get that kill. He's going to get two kills, in fact, before I can even get to him. There's another person in the bomb site. He's going to be spamming away. He's coming in the tunnels. Major and Uzi are going to get two kills and going to take them down, which is going to leave the B bomb site early open. But that early kill has bought a bit of time for his teammates. So Stav has kind of come around the back as well and took down Uzi. So Ozstriker and Major are in a 2v1 situation against CLY. Who do you back in this situation? CLY is going to get Major, so it's a 1v1. CLY versus Ozstriker. The moment of truth. Can Ozstriker hold his nerve? And in fact, you know what? He said, I'm not even bothered about that duel. He fails to jump on the box to get up short. He's got 20 seconds. He's going like Usain Bolt to the other B bomb site.
But CLY is thinking he would go back to B, so Ozstriker really should win this round.
Yeah, he really should. He really, really should. So it is the moment of truth. Ozstriker, please. Please, bro. So you've got to win this. So he's going to drop down into spawn and peek. He doesn't know where he is, and you can see where he is on the X-ray. The blue ghost left for dead. He's lost the duel at range. Got himself into a ridiculous, horrible position. He should have stayed behind the boxes and played for time. Now CLY is going to get the defuse, and that's going to make it 9-6.
A ridiculous big risk going down the C to spawn there. I mean, he should have stayed in the slope area, just peeking to find out where CLY was. And yeah, pretty weird decision from both players, I would say. But yeah, CLY played great.
How can a player that experience make that mistake?
You mean what decision?
Yeah, well, yeah, but he's an experienced player, so why has he made that wrong decision to drop down there? Because even I can see that.
Yeah,
bad.
Exactly. And if I don't know what he must have thought he was going through the long or catwalk area. But then he surely would have heard him when he was going to plant.
Yeah.
Because you can't walk that fast.
Yeah, you can't. Yeah, of course you can't.
So it really makes no sense.
I'm baffled by what I've seen. So TCM have done an absolutely great job, I think. They definitely looked, like you said, individually, I feel stronger. And there was a lot of comments in the chat, people saying, wow, imaginary are bad at this game. I don't think you should necessarily tar everyone with the same brush. And of course, you should take into consideration, this is the opening game of a big tournament. There's a lot of games to come in this group stage, and we'll definitely be talking a bit more about that later. But we're about to go live again. So this is the second half of the opening game. You can see all the HFs being spammed, and so let's see what's going to happen here. And we've got X-ray on after some people were grumbling about it. I don't feel like it's default, but we put it on for you. MSHZ is going to get the first kill. CLY going to answer back. Tornado Tony's going to as well give TCM a lead. So if they take this pistol, it's going to put them in a great position. Uzi's pretty low as well, so Stavros, but it is a numerical advantage. 4v3 for TCM. We're now going to wrap around all the way to long. They're trying to push and pull imaginary into various positions. So Uzi very low again, getting spammed at long. He's going to make the call. They're coming up long. And as you can see from the X-ray, he's probably going to run into someone on short here, so he needs to be alert. Oh, that's a great little reaction shot on Stavros. He was low, fair enough, but Uzi played that pretty well. And you can see that TCM now are kind of, where do we go? What do we do? So they're just going to go for it. But Tornado Tony, as we were talking about in the build-up, he's going to go aggressive. CLY is going to get another kill. Tornado Tony spamming that Glock at distance. He's not going to get it. Ozstriker is going to kill Strug. CLY is going to get another kill, though. So all of a sudden, this is it. The two-star players in a 1v1 situation. But CLY could be killed with a flashbang right now. So
still only one burst with the Glock in this game.
Yeah, yeah. So the Glock is OP to the max, so anything's possible. Shucks, he's going to try and play it. Oh my god, you've got to hit him! Uh-huh. And he does, and in the end, a needless, gratuitous headshot to win the round. But as you said, one burst could have totally changed that, though, and Shucks
missed
it.
What's he doing? Is it? Oh.
Nah, he's fine.
Yeah, it was a bug on my monitor.
Oh, right.
It looked like he like let go of the diffuse, and I was like, what?
No. He's he managed to hold down E. So a great pistol round there for imaginary. I think they needed that to really stay in the game. I feel like if TCM had won that pistol, it could have been curtains.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's still very, very hard for them. So, but there is a chance. There's a chance.
I mean, CT-wise, how do you think you'll see imaginary set up?
I mean, just the standard, I would think, like two guys short, one guy taking long, or two guys going aggressive long, one guy defending.
Yeah, we had some butchery there on short. And in the NTCM, I've kind of come out of it with Stabros picking up a couple of kills. So, I mean, I still think they're going to lose this round, but they are pushing on to the A bomb site, getting quite a bit of penetration there. So they're farming the pistols away at long. Shocks has gone in for Wazda. He does what he wants. He jumps around. He evades the bullets. And in the end, it's MSHZ who comes around from the back and gets the kill. So no surprise there. What about from the TCM perspective? Do you think it's worth isolating players? I know we've talked about this before. Is it worth isolating a player? Like, say, for example, if you know someone, say, for example, a striker is having not a great game, do you go and find out where he's playing and then isolate him and really turn the screw, or can you not play like that?
It's very uncommon to play like that, I would say. I mean,
because it used to happen in sports, people used to do that.
Really?
Yeah, people would find out where their worst player was playing. They would push them, and then they would try and make them feel psychologically bad by losing a lot of rounds in a row.
Well, in 1.6, it was more like, especially in Dust 2, it was more, the defense was more dynamic, so it was more about how two players work together than like if one player has that aim. Seems like an easy round for Imaginary.
Yeah, well, I was going to say, and this is a full buy, of course, don't forget, from TCM. So Imaginary have managed to shut this down pretty well. There's only Uzi who's dead. It's a 4v2 situation. You can see Mage having a look at Long, and in the end, SMSHZ, he's managed not to kill Major that time. He did pretty well because he was close. He's definitely put the team kill incident behind him. Major's just going to move around it short, and let's get to Clutch Cam. CLY, he's managed to get the bomb. You know what? He could get a plant here.
Yeah, but Shoxi heard him, so Shoxi is going to kill him from behind. So even if he gets the plants, he's going to lose his
round. Still, it's still a good plant from given the situation. But in the end, yeah, you're absolutely right again.
Yeah.
Your crystal ball, right? Your crystal ball. You can pick my lottery numbers tonight. But yeah, so that's going to tie it up at 9 for 9. Again, you can see from the frag charts, we've got 23 kills overall for 12 deaths for Shoxi. That's about right. CLY, though, edging just ahead with 24 for 10. He's had a great game, really great game. And this is a player who, let's not forget, he was effectively kicked from MTW for his combination of ability and attitude. So I'm very surprised to see him playing so well here. Perhaps he shouldn't be. So they're going full eco onto this box out here. You can see that imaginary old striker. He's going to gobble up these eco frags, these confidence frags. He needs them. He's going to get another one, and Shoxi's going to get another one as well. And then Shoxi's going to get another one. He doesn't need confidence frags at all.
Quite bad luck there from old striker not getting any of those frags.
Yeah, I think he grabbed a couple at the start, but he probably should have had a few more. Yeah. So, but there you go. It's 10 for 9. So the French have edged back into the lead. I think we've got a vital round coming up now, because it's going to be interesting to see what TCM do to kind of stop the rot. But it's, so far, it's been very cut and thrust. And I totally agree with your assessment that what we've got is we've got one side playing tactically well, one side playing individually better. So it's going to be interesting to see how this pans out now.
Quite odd though, as German teams usually play very good tactics.
Yeah, exactly. But I think this is the shift that we've seen in kind of the German scene right now. You know, you have got some great individuals, but we won't speculate about that just now. We'll bring that together in the post-match maybe. Ostriker pretty low on health again, so's Uzi. So there's initial exchanges, the nades have all gone the way. He made it blind at long, he's spamming away through that smoke. Stavros is going to get a nade kill onto Uzi, that low HP coming in. And then CLY, Tornado Tony with two big kills. So this round absolutely played to perfection by TCM. The belated crab claw round the back from Stavros. And that was just a beautifully executed split.
Yeah, absolutely. And I can't stress how important it is to win like a round flawlessly. You get so much money like for the next round. So a big win there for TCM.
So absolutely what they needed, 10 all. I mean, so far, while I think perhaps the skill level hasn't been as high as what some people would have hoped for, it's definitely been an entertaining and exciting game, and I hope it's the measure of things to come from the Mad Catz CSGO Invitational. But you can see as well that right now TCM have decided we've just won that round flawlessly. Now we're going to mess with your heads, and we're just going to play very, very passive as T. So they've spread out evenly across the map. You can see Stavros here is going to go for a little smoke. Just going to throw that down on short. And it's MSHZ who's got that edge on CLY. So that's going to be a big factor in the round. CLY probably should have evaded that. But We're just having a little look around the map. He's gone, and MSAT is going to get another one. But in the meantime, Flo has managed to get onto that A-bomb site. Ozstrike is going to get a kill onto him, and Uzi's going to pick up the next kill. So Struxy, Imaginary, might be able to do to TCM what TCM just did to them. So what a great way to answer back. You win a flawless round, we win a flawless round.
Yeah, that was a bit of bad luck for TCM. Yeah, I don't think you noticed it, but Stavey jumped from short into CT spawn. And he was just about to kill Major in the back, and then they would have gotten the bomb site. But then, like, he aimed for his head, and then he got killed in the back by Mash. So that was like key to that round.
Right. Well, it's going to give the French the narrowest of leads, 11-10, and they're battling away at the moment, battling away through the difficulties they faced against this German side. So. Again, TCM, I mean, they played this last round slow and it didn't really work out for them. Perhaps they need to be a bit more aggressive. Looks like that's what we're going to see. We're on Tornado Tony cam. He was going to go short, but he's thrown down some flashes and nades. I think a smoke as well. And then he's dropped back to long, thought about it, going for that long flash over the top. He's going to turn his back quickly. Is he going to drop down into mid? No, he's going to spam into that lower B bomb site area before pushing up short. And you can see he's got two of his compatriots moved up there with him. So they are going to get onto the same bomb site. There's only one player there as well. So they're going to get that spam away and stab us on MSAT. But Ozstrike is going to get one. Major's going to get another. Tornado Tony and Struxy are going to answer back. Give them a 3v2 advantage. You can see as well that Imaginary have got one at long, so they can get the safe plant down here behind the boxes. Tornado Tony's just going to quickly put that down. Ozstrike in his favorite position. He's in CT spawn. He's just going to quickly run up. He's going to go for some sort of jumping headshot. I don't know why you're doing it, Oz. Don't do it. Don't do it to yourself. CLY is going to answer back. So it's all on Uzi. He's put Uzi in a ridiculous position. He needs to be crisp here. We need to see some Shoxy one bullet skills from Uzi. Tornado Tony's low, and it looks like he said, I'm out, boys. I haven't got that X factor, and he's just going to go back to long and try and save his gun. So, again, this is probably as even as a game as I've actually casted ever. Yeah. Like, it's 11 for 11 again. No one's had any distinctive advantage at any point in the game. It's been real bitty. I don't think anyone's won more than three rounds in a row. So, it's okay. Now that we're at the crucial point, how do you see it going? Do you want to change your prediction? Are Imaginary Gaming going to triumph, or do you want to switch to my prediction?
I think TCM will win now, actually.
It's
a lot of... this round is like the key round to the game, I think both teams are really low on money. TCM might have a slight advantage there, but I think they will do their short push as they did last round. It's quite common in CSGO that you push short and two guys jump down the seat to spawn and like run up to A that way, and you just try to like kill the guy on A from both sides.
Well, history repeating itself here. MSHZ, who's starting to get hot at a very crucial time in the game, he's took down the Danger Man from TCM, CLY, and that's going to enable, I would say, TCM to, you know, like, sure, they're going to have to commit to this B bomb site. They're going to get butchered. Tornado Tony's got took down as well, and that was, again, so crucial. I just feel if CLY dies at the start of a round, I just do not see what TCM are going to do, because right now, he is the guy. He is the guy that's going to make it happen. And again, we're quickly looking at the frag charts just to put that in perspective. CLY with 26 kills, 13 deaths, a 2 KPD ratio. And at the top, you've got Shoxy, 29 for 14. So he's loving it. But that round means that TCM are now going to have to do an eco. MSHC, full of confidence. CLY, he's had a couple of rounds. He's had to exit early, being that first frag, which has been absolutely vital to how the rounds have panned out.
Look at UC, he's going behind
him. Yeah. I'm going to quickly try and get onto him. I did get there in time, so we missed that. But here we go, the push onto B. Shock's going for a flash over the top while Major takes down a kill. There's two Pistolias running onto this B bomb site. And in the end, CLY it is. Who else? He's managed to go into the crouch, the impenetrable crouch, get that kill. But it's not going to make any difference to the round. And daylight starting to open up for the French. I probably should ask you if you want to swap back.
I don't know.
It's your last chance.
I would say TCM still.
Right, okay. So he's changed. He's changed, guys. I don't know. The French, I might have to start saying Zoutalo, because they're definitely coming back into this. And look at that from SHZ, just confidence, just oozing from every pore at the moment. Just pushes up mid, goes for that early pick in Suicide Alley and gets it. And it's Tornado Tony this time that's taking out the round. Not CLI, but that's still definitely going to be a factor. And TCM are looking like rabbits in the headlights right now. They're really struggling to put together any cohesive strats. They're spreading out across the map. They're giving Imaginary the first frag. This is when the pressure comes in. This is when players need to step up and be at their best. Stavros is trying. He's took down Ozstriker from Imaginary, which, as we've established, that's vital. Vitally important. Ozstriker, though, I think it's some sort of weird belated nade. Oh, no, it wasn't Ozstriker he took down. I apologize. Sorry, I thought he killed Ozstriker. I couldn't see because it was flash. Ozstriker's still very much alive, people. And with two kills, make that three. So he has given them this round, and now you're only two rounds away from victory, one round away from at least securing a draw in this opening group stage, and I just don't see how TCM can get back into this. This round, so important. Shoxi has gone for 31 frags across both halves, and of course there's still rounds to be played. So
yeah, now I want to switch back again.
Yeah, I thought so. I thought you might say that.
Yeah,
it's just why we didn't have any money on this, bro.
The early frag there from Ash was due to that round. I mean, they tried to do their short push, which had worked for them before, and I thought it would work again, but there were one guy down thanks to Mash, so it didn't work this time.
Well, this eco round, again, it doesn't feel like they're playing it with any importance. They've run up long. They've kind of committed to the draw now by doing this. You can see Struxy's got an M4, which he's picked up from the guy that CLY managed to kill, which was Uzi. CLY's out of the round now, so it's pretty much important that Struxy does something with this gun that they've picked up. He's just lurking in the pit, just waiting for someone to peek, hoping for a long distance one bullet. Well, I'm not too sure anything's going to happen. It looks like Imaginary are just too savvy here. They're being disciplined. They're not peeking. They're not doing anything. They're forcing Struxy into moving. And you can see that Flo's trying to bait them out with a pistol. And that is just one of those moments. Takes out the smoke over crossover. MSHZ peaks at the right time. Gets them both. And that is 15 rounds. And I think we're going to see 16-11. So my prediction, looking to be wrong. Who knows, though? We could be seeing some incredible four-round momentum comeback. But I don't understand really what's gone wrong here for TCM. It's like they just forgot tactically what to do. But again, I won't talk about that now. We will talk about that in just a moment when we do the post-match analysis. I'm pretty sure it's going to be coming soon. You can see Shoxi. It looks like, is he going to go aggressive? No, he's going to hold his discipline, just hold on to this B-bomb site. You can see from the X-ray where they are. Ozstriker's in that camping spot there, just at the crossover point. And TCM have fallen back, and that's great play from Stavros. He's managed to get two kills as Imaginary got a bit greedy and decided to push around the back, and he's took them down in mid to make it a 4v3 situation, although Stavros very low on HP at the moment, only got 6 HP, but it's still an advantage. MSHZ is as well. He's pretty low. TCM's going to be this duel in the smoke. Shox has come up big, and in the end, it's CLY has got a headshot. Are we going to see a plant here? We've got a bit of lag coming in. We've got Stavros. He's had a huge round here with that three, man. Absolutely huge from him. But CLY's got near full health. It's all on Ozstriker again. The clutch king. And Stavros has kept TCM in the game with a huge individual round. Talk about players needing to come up big. Four kills with a great double.
Yeah, great player there from Stavie. Was actually kind of fun how Major and I think it was UC actually flanked them, being around in T-spawn when they were going back from long. And somehow they didn't manage to kill a single one when they rotated back.
It was just Stavros, just insta-dinked both of them with, I mean, you can either put that down to luck or you can put that down to skill, but who cares at this stage in a game where you need every round to get something out of it. But that's going to give TCM a bit of confidence. They're going to start believing that maybe it's not so impossible. And all of a sudden, you can see the difference it makes. They're pinging their flashes around. They're pinging their smokes around. They're not afraid to peek. They've got guns in their hands. They're confident again. And this is what they needed to be doing. They should have been doing this four or five rounds ago. I don't understand why they weren't. It was a complete change. They just froze. But it's all about what Imaginary are going to do. Tornado Tony is going to get that first frag, so we're going to quickly go up on shore. Stay with the danger man here, Stavros. He's the guy who's been individually brilliant. Forced Imaginary to drop down. Ozstriker's got two, and MSHZ is going to turn it around. So Ozstriker picking up a quick double strut has gone round the back, but in the end, it's not going to make any difference. It is going to be the first game in the Madcat CSGO Invitational. Does go the way of the French, does go the way of Imaginary. Your initial prediction was actually right. So, yeah. So, I think we're... where to begin with that? 16-12. I guess let's talk about the victory.